Charlotte's one of my home tracks. You know, that's a place where I honestly don't feel pressure. I'm near home, and it's a great time. I've grown up going to Charlotte Motor Speedway throughout the years of being around my family, with them being in racing. So Charlotte's a place that means a lot to me, and to be able to go run there is really special. And especially in the Coke 600, it's a very long race, and what it stands for is awesome. So being able to be a part of it, I'm very proud of a driver and an American. You know, it's very a special holiday, and I think we all honestly take it for granted. We're very thankful for it, but for what it means and who has laid their life down for our country and sacrificed it for our country, it means a lot to us. So it's really special to be able to represent that during the weekend of the Coke 600, and I'm proud to be a part of it.
I served in 3rd Battalion, 3rd Marines Weapons Company, 81 Splatoon, Marine Corps Base Hawaii. I grew up with an all-military family, so my dad and my other two uncles are Army, and my grandfather's Marine, so I kind of followed my grandfather. You know, seeing their names out there and the fact that their families are able to see it every year is awesome. It's a little more pressure because you want to show the name off, but it's also great to see leading up to the race all those service members that you can see during the week, and then at the race itself, they're everywhere, and it's really cool to see. I grew up watching it. I watched it when I was in the military as well, so I know you can be any part of the world watching it. It's awesome.
Racing that weekend, you know, you feel kind of the enthusiasm to celebrate, you know, all the servicemen that weekend at the racetrack. And I think that just, you know, the whole weekend becomes about that. And I think that you kind of realize that from the first time you walk in the garage to the moment of silence to everything that kind of goes on throughout the weekend. You just realize how it's a great weekend to lift those guys up and think about them more than you would on a normal weekend. It makes you stop and pause for a little bit, right? You just think about the military displays that they'll have going, you know, helicopters there and people roping down and things that you don't think about that you don't normally have on a normal weekend, right? So I think it makes you stop and pause and kind of think a little deeper about some of the sacrifices that people have given, you know, for us to be in this country and have freedoms and enjoy what we do. Where you're able to take a little more time and just kind of think about that for a second and kind of ponder, you know, and be thankful that we get to race and we get to do some of these things that we do all because of them.
I think that, you know, for me, just being in NASCAR and the job that they've done around, you know, the Coke 600 and Memorial Day weekend really put it in perspective for me. NASCAR's done a great job of giving us this opportunity to represent those families and those fallen men and women. And you feel that weight of it. It's a big weekend. And like I said, the personal side of it, of meeting those family members, is what made it very real and very close to home. A lot of the pre-race activities, you definitely stay in that moment. Every driver and every team and every, you know, family member that you're representing is a different scenario. But, you know, I've had the privilege to have those close family members there, and they come to the driver's meeting with you, they come to chapel, they come to driver introduction. So that part, you know, is very engaged in what's happening. I think that we all feel the weight and the responsibility to not only represent those families, but represent all servicemen and women and understand the importance and appreciation of what they do. It's a reflection of our country. It's a reflection of who we are. And our sport does a good job of that. We know the importance of freedom, and we know that freedom isn't free, that it came at a cost. And I think just being aware of that and understanding that and then putting that on display in front of millions of people is the hope is that servicemen and women and family members of servicemen and women are encouraged and that they feel appreciated and that they feel valued.
I think we just want them to understand how much we appreciate their service, you know, how excited we are to go out and race on this weekend and celebrate them. You know, I think that's the big thing is, you know, we should do this all the time and it should be every weekend, but here's the one weekend where we take extra time to commend them and appreciate everything that they've done, the people who've lost their lives. I think that, you know, from the bottom of our hearts, we just want them to understand, you know, how much we appreciate all that and look forward to being a part of that weekend.
what they did or what their family member did was important and it's significant, because it is, and we all know that. And so that's what the goal of the weekend is for us, is to make that at the forefront.
We appreciate your service more than we could ever imagine, right? It's very special for us to do what we do, and especially to live in a free country. And we hope you enjoy the weekend and be proud of it.